Hey, I'm Mike, and I wanted to show you how to remove background noise in Adobe Premiere Pro CC. Get involved in one of my upcoming audio production courses. They open every couple of months for enrollment, and I always accept a maximum of 20 students each time, so I can provide personal one-on-one coaching to each and every student. If you'd like to learn more about the world of audio, head to mrc.fm/learn. So here we are in the sequence of Adobe Premiere Pro, and I'm just using my internal camera microphone to show you how it's possible to eliminate noise, even if you're using a low quality microphone. First, we'll go over from this sequence area here, the editing workspace, into the audio workspace so we can work with audio. And the first thing I'm going to do is assign this as dialogue and add a preset here to be balanced male voice. This will increase
students for enrollment every couple of months. If you're interested, head over to mrc.fm/learn.
Now, as you can probably hear, there's a lot of background noise there, a fan going off, all that kind of stuff. And it's not really that good quality audio either, but there are certain things we can do inside Adobe Premiere Pro to make this better. We want to eliminate the fan noise, and we also want to eliminate maybe a little bit of the room reverb as well. So over here in the audio track mixer, usually this display will be hidden. It'll look like this when you first get into it. You just pop out this triangle to show and hide the effects panel. And inside the effects panel on audio track one, I can now drop down and go to noise reduction and restoration. And I got some really good stuff, but we'll want to focus on DeNoise and DeReverb. Starting with DeNoise, this is absolutely fantastic. Once I've added that, I bring this up and watch how it works. So let's start off at 0% applied. It's just a slider, really, up to 100%.
For enrollment every couple of months. If you're interested,
and now if we go to the end,
mrc.fm/learn,
you can hear that fan noise up to 100%, and the fan will disappear.
/learn,
completely gone. Listen to that.
/learn.
Gone.
Interested, head over to mrc.fm/learn.
Already, just with that DeNoise effect, amazing that what it does to your voice.
If you're interested, head over to mrc.fm/learn.
And then reducing it again, bringing back all of the noise in the background. So let's put that up to maybe not 100%, maybe 42.
mrc.fm/learn.
And with that, it has pretty much done a good job of reducing the background noise. Then I can go on and add the noise reduction restoration DeReverb effect. And this is exactly the same setup as DeNoise. It's one slider. And the further I push this over, the more it is going to fade out the background echo from my room.
If you're interested, head over to mrc.fm/learn.
Now, of course, you're losing quite a lot of the quality of the voice because it's doing some pretty harsh processing on your audio. But if you have recorded in an environment where you've got a lot of echo and there's not much you can do about it, sliding up the DeReverb slider here can make a big difference. Let's play it back again and listen to the difference.
Take part in one of my upcoming audio production classes. I accept a maximum of 20 students.
And let's also check it out on this little clap here that I do just before I start speaking. So there's a clap with a lot of echo, and then up at 100%. It's much snappier. Much snappier. And then back down. So yeah, DeReverb's really good. And what you'll notice as well is there's an auto gain going on here. So of course, the more it is editing the audio to get rid of that reverb, it's reducing the gain of your audio. But with auto gain enabled, it's pushing it back up so you're not losing any amplitude on the audio signal. So DeNoise, DeReverb, absolutely fantastic to stick on your FX toolkit here in the audio workspace. And of course, take advantage of essential sound, maybe even choose a preset just to make your dialogue sound a little bit better in Adobe Premiere Pro CC. Let me know how you get on and your experience with DeNoise and DeReverb in the comments below.